Good morning, students. I am Sapna, your science teacher. Today I am going to teach you first chapter of physics of first term. Name of the chapter is matter. Now I am going to tell you about the topics related to matter which we will discuss today in this video. First one, matter, its meaning and composition. Then we will discuss states of matter, solids, liquids and gases. Then we will discuss characteristics of solids, liquids and gases. Basically we will discuss in this chapter their shape, texture and volume. Next we will discuss distinguishing properties of solid, liquids and gases. Now, today we will start with matter. Basically, you have seen maximum object around you like flower, tree, water, stone, pen, eraser and many more things around you. Now see, in chapter they have given you some examples of the object like rocks, stones, flowers, table, pen, pencil which I have in my hand, book which I use to explain you, salt, sugar, water and many more. All these things are matter. Why all these things are matter? Because all these things having basically two character, mass, and all these objects occupy space. Occupy space. Which two main basic characteristics these objects having? One mass, another these object occupy space. Mass, then occupy space. Now same thing they have given. All these objects have mass and they occupy space. Underline these two words, mass, then underline occupy space. Clear? Now you will underline definition of matter. Matter is defined as anything that has mass and occupy space. Matter are those things which has mass and occupy space. Now we know two characteristics, mass and occupy space. Now you think about air. We use air for breathing process. We use air for breathing process. Through nostril, we inhale oxygen. We exhale carbon dioxide. It is not visible through our eyes, but even then, this air, it is a state of matter. What it is? State of matter. Then we think about planets. Planets in the universe. All these things are matter. What are these? Matter. What are these? Matter. Now see the table given in the book. Types of matter. how many types? Living matter, then non-living matter. Living matter, we know living things are plants, animals, birds, amphibians, reptiles. All are living matter. Non-living matter are categorized in two forms, natural and man-made. Natural and man-made. Table you have seen in the book, they have given types of matter. Types of matter, it categorizes in two forms. One is living matter, another one non-living matter. In case of living matter, they have given you two category, plants and animals. We can consider birds also. In case of non-living matter, some are natural and some are man-made. Natural things, birds, plants, animals, different sort of birds, you know, different sorts of plants, you know, and different types of animals, you know very well. In case of birds, I give you one or two examples, many more you know very well. Sparrow, parrot. In case of plants, many trees are there, herbs are there, shrubs are there. Case of animals, lion, fish, horse, and many more animals exist on this earth. So these birds, plants, animals, it categorize under living matter. These are matter. In case of non-living matter, natural and man-made are there. In case of natural, air is there, water, sun, stars. In case of man-made, we can say pen, pencil, table, window, etc. This way, we can see that living matter and non-living matter exist on earth, all are types of matter. Clear? All are types of matter. See the activity. In this activity, they have given name of different object to whom we have to classify. Which name they have given? See, tree, table, window, book, teacher, blackboard, water, sandwich, chair, air, classmates. We have to distinguish all this given object in living matter or non-living matter. In table, they have categorized them. In case of living matter, tree, teacher, classmates are there. In non-living matter, table, window, book, blackboard, water and sandwich. These objects come under the category of non-living matter. Now, we will discuss characteristics of matter. How many characteristics they have given? Matter has mass. Matter occupies space. First characteristic is matter has mass. Matter has mass. Now, what is mass? It is amount or quantity. What is mass? It is amount or quantity of matter. amount or quantity of matter in an object, and we call it as mass. What we call it as mass of the object. Amount or quantity of matter in an object is called as mass. The first characteristics of matter: matter has mass. Amount or quantity of matter in an object is called as mass. Now, how we can prove that matter having mass? Now, if we take two balloons, that two balloons are inflated. Inflated means these balloons are filled with air. And from the center, we suspend this rod with some thread. When we suspend it, both the balloon or the rod, that is horizontal. But if we prick one balloon, air will escape out from it. When air will escape out from it, then the rod, it become bent toward the balloon which is filled with the air. It means this balloon having mass. Why it having the mass? Due to the presence of air inside it. Now see, in the book they have given first line, matter has mass. First line, the amount or quantity of matter in an object is called its mass. Underline this line, definition of mass it is. And experiment they have given that two balloons, same, filled with the air, then rod will be horizontal because it is balanced due to inflated balloons. When we prick one balloon, then rod will tilt down toward the inflated balloon. Rod will tilt down toward the inflated balloon. Second characteristics, matter occupies space. Under these characteristics, we come to know the maximum objects. When we place anywhere, they occupy space. Suppose I place one bottle here. Now this bottle occupies space when I hold it like this. I draw outlining. You are able to find out how much space occupied by this bottle. Now see, this much space occupied by this bottle. When I keep this medicine bottle here, once again I will mark outlining. You will see how much space occupied by this bottle. So same way, when we keep anything anywhere, that thing occupy space. For example, if we take 5 ml water in measuring cylinder, 5 ml water in measuring cylinder, and then we pour the same water in wide mouthed container, its volume or space occupied by that liquid is same, 5 ml only. Now we can see these wattles. Here they have given the capacity of this liquid 1.33 liter. It means when we keep this bottle with this volume, it having capability to occupy space. Clear? So matter occupies space, one example already I have given. So what it is basically, that is amount of space. What it is? Amount of space occupied by matter. Amount of space occupied by matter.
Okay.
Start. Matter occupies space. All matter occupies space, we know very well. Amount of space that matter occupy is known as volume. Underline this line. Amount of space that matter occupies is known as its volume. Now example what they have given. We have bottle 10 ml of water. It means that water in the bottle, it occupy how much space? 10 ml. How much space? 10 ml. Same way, all solids or gases, all occupy space. I have already shown you this bottle. Now you can see what it is written here. 5 ml. What it is written? 5. Here it is written 5 ml. Same way, in the book, they give the capacity of one bottle. That is 10 ml and it occupy how much? 10 ml of space. Now, next we will discuss composition of matter. Composition of matter. All these matters, whether the matters are living matter, whether matters are non-living. All these matter basically made up of atoms or molecules. All these matter are made up of basically from atoms or molecules. Atom and molecules, these are the tiny particles. You can say invisible particles, which are not visible through our eyes. So basic structure, atoms or molecules formed. Composition of matter. All matters are made up of tiny particles, underline it. We call it atoms or molecules. Atoms cannot exist independently, underline this. So they combine with other atom to form molecules. These both atoms and molecules are not visible through human eye. Molecules of matter, they may contain one type of atoms or different types of atoms. In book, we read that atom, it cannot exist independently. So atom, it combine with other atoms. Suppose this one is atom. So this atom not exist independently. It always combine with other atoms to form one molecule. Atom combine with another atom to form one molecule. So, I will give you one example. Sometime, atom combine with same type of atom to form one molecule. Example is oxygen. This is the formula of oxygen. It means two atoms of oxygen combine to form one molecule of oxygen. Same type of atoms combine to form one molecule. Second one, atoms can combine with different atoms also. When it combines with different types of atoms, they also form one molecule. For example, water. Formula of water is H2O. So H2O is a formula of water in which two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combine to form one molecule of water. In this case, two different type of atoms combine to form one molecule. In some cases, same type of atoms are combined to form one molecule. And sometimes, different type of atoms combine to form one molecule. Now, we will discuss about states of matter. States of matter. What is matter? Now you come to know very well that anything that has mass and occupies space is known as matter. So now states of matter. Matter exists in three states. Solid, liquid and gas. Solid, liquid and gas. These are the three states of matter. In case of solid, we can take the example of this solid. In case of liquid, we can take the example of this bottle in which liquid is present. This one is liquid. And in case of gases, in room, air is present, number of gases are present. So, these molecules are free to move anywhere. In solid states, atoms or molecules. We know atom cannot exist independently. It always exists in molecules form. So, in case of solid, these molecules are arranged tightly. These molecules are arranged tightly with each other. There is no space between the molecule in case of solid. So these molecules in solid have more intermolecular force. These molecules are tightly packed. These are attached with each other due to intermolecular force, which is more in solid. That's why these molecules are attached tightly. But there is less intermolecular space. In diagram, we are able to see that there is no space. These molecules are tightly packed, so less intermolecular space. Due to these two properties, more intermolecular force, less intermolecular space, these solids having definite shape and volume. In case of liquid, we can see the arrangement of molecule in this liquid. Space is present between two molecules, and molecules are free to move in the given space. So here, more molecules, more molecular space than solid. So in case of liquid, more molecular space is present than the solid. And here, intermolecular force is weaker than solid. That's why these molecules having ability to flow. They don't have definite shape, but liquid have fixed volume. Gas, third state of matter. In this state, molecules are free to move anywhere in all direction. In case of gases, molecules are free to move. Molecules are free to move in all direction. So in gases, intermolecular force is too weaker. That's why gases, they do not have fixed shape and volume. See in the book that about matter, we already learned that it is made up of tiny particles called atoms or molecules. And packing of these material different in various materials. In some materials, they are closely packed, underline it. While in other, they are loosely packed, underline it. Then according to the matter, it is classified as solid, liquid and gas. Already I explained, these are known as states of matter. So hence, matter exists in three states, solid, liquid and gases. These states have different characteristics. Difference, for example, differ in shape, volume and compressibility. Differ in shape, volume and compressibility. Now see the activity 2. Aim to study shape, volume and compressibility of solid, liquid and gas. On basis of shape, volume and compressibility, we can differentiate three states of matter. Here they have given you diagram of cork, water and one gas, hydrogen, it is filled in balloon. So these three states they specify in this activity. Cork is solid, water liquid and hydrogen is a gas. Now see what observation you can see or absorb by seeing cork, water and hydrogen. We will see that this cork, it is a wooden piece. Solid it is. So it has definite shape, definite volume, but we cannot compress it. Water has no shape, have definite volume, but does not compress. Gas has no shape, no definite volume, and can be compressed. Now see, I have a solid in my hand. If I want to press it, it is not possible for me because this one is solid. Solid does not compress. It has definite shape and size. It having fixed volume. Second one, liquid. I have liquid in this glass. Definite volume it having. Now see the shape of water in the glass. It is same as a glass having the shape. If I pour this water in this dish or in this container, you can check the shape of water. It is same as the shape of this dish or container. Volume is fixed, but shape is not fixed. So it changes in which container we are putting this liquid. And we cannot compress liquid also. If I fill this glass full with water and I want to pack it up, we are not able to compress it. Third case, gas. In this balloon, gas is filled. Now, gas does not have its fixed shape. What is the shape of this balloon? The same shape it acquire. If we have small one, then shape of the gas like this small balloon. Then it do not have fixed volume, not definite volume. We can compress it. Inside it, when we blow air inside it, with the pressure, it stored in this balloon. It means we compress gas inside it. So solid have definite shape, definite volume, but we cannot compress it. Liquid have definite volume but not fixed shape, and we cannot compress it. In case of gases, do not have fixed shape, do not have fixed volume, but we can compress gases easily. Now, in case of shape, they have given about solid, cork, fixed shape, does not change its shape unless broken or cut. Second one, related to liquid, they have given water. Water changes its shape according to the vessel it is poured into. When it placed in a bottle, it take the shape of the bottle, and when it placed in a bowl, it take the shape of bowl. Gas, hydrogen, it also changes shape according to where it is put into. When put in a balloon, it acquire the shape of the balloon. When put in a jar, it acquire the shape of the jar. So basic observation, solids has fixed shape, liquid and gas have no fixed shape. I think everybody clear. Solids have fixed shape while liquid and gas have no fixed shape. Next is volume. Solid does not change its size and its volume. It remains same unless it is broken. In case of water, liquid, certain volume of water we can take. For example, they have given 10 ml liquid we have taken. We pour 10 ml in bowl, in beaker. We observe the volume of water remain same. So volume of liquid does not change even though its shape change. In case of gases, hydrogen gas. When we fill the balloon with gas and when we prick it, gas is released out. Gas occupies the entire space in the room. This means gas occupy space, but volume is not fixed. So solids and liquid have definite volume, underline it, but gas has no fixed volume. Compressibility. Solid. When we apply pressure on the cork or any solid, you observe when I press that solid, it cannot compress. In case of liquid, when we pour into the bottle, we close it lid attached to the piston. Then we can push that piston inside to try to compress it. Then we observe that water cannot be compressed. Third point related to gases. Fill gas in a balloon and try to compress the balloon. You will observe the gas can compress into lesser space. That already we have seen when we compress one balloon. We will continue with the same chapter in next class. Your homework is, you will read chapter, learn key terms and find out answers of test yourself part 1 from chapter matter. Thank you very much.